whoa, whoa, whoa. Once you cross that line, it ain't no trying to fix it. You want me to forgive you, let's be realistic. I can't kick it with your kind like I tore my meniscus. How you go from co-defending to a witness? They'll stand on couches with you but won't stand on business. Whoa, I watched everybody turn on my brother like he ain't have him out here flying jets. Ridiculous.
What's up, Hog Nation? I'm Coy Fondo.
I'm Braden Marshall.
And this is Hog Nest.
Welcome to episode 16.
Dude, our Hog Nest crew has been busy this week.
Yeah, tell me about it.
All hands on deck. All in, no exceptions.
The result is that we have quite the lineup for you guys this week.
Let's go ahead and get right into it with a quick plug for our Florida Apartments Valentine's Day Carnation Sale.
I'm Cassie Riley, and I'm here with
Ariana.
Ariana.
And they're part of the H.J. Floral Team. So, tell me more about the H.J. Carnation.
It's a fundraiser florals doing to raise money. Basically, it's a Valentine's Day fundraiser where you can send someone flowers with a message and a note. One flower is $3 and two flowers is $5.
So, where can we buy these flowers?
They can be bought on the stage or you can buy them from Miss Outlaw's class, which is in the Ag Shop. And they are due February 8th through 9th.
Thank y'all.
Do you have someone to buy flowers for, Coy?
Do you have someone to give flowers to?
World remains a mystery.
Indeed.
Spring letterman fittings will be February 21st during study hall. If you believe you qualify for a jacket, stop by at the front office to pick up.
Cheer tryouts are fast approaching. Anyone interested in joining H.J. Cheer must attend a mandatory informational parent and candidate meeting on either February 7th or 8th in the HJHS library at 6 p.m. Stands for Hardin Jefferson High School, folks.
If you didn't know that. Zap will be held this Saturday from 8 to 10. Come clear up those zeros. Must be on time and have your student identification card.
Seniors, if you would like to purchase a yearbook ad, like this one, please see Miss Ochoa or your yearbook rep. I know that all of us seniors have heard relentlessly to make sure to fill out your FAFSA, fill out your FAFSA. So we thought to drive that point home as if it's not been already, we'd get the information straight from the source herself, Miss McLeod.
Hi, I'm Maddox Harrod, and we're here with the senior counselor, Miss McLeod. We're here to ask her about FAFSA, or FAFSA. So can you explain what FAFSA is and its purpose?
Okay, it's a federal application for funding, which means money from the government for school, for college, whatever. And so you can apply for it to get literally just grants, just free money. Or this also helps you qualify for really low interest loans for college.
Okay, thank you. And who is all eligible to apply for it?
Oh, basically anybody. I mean, if you're a senior and you're wanting to go to college, you can apply for it. Also, once you get into college, you still have to fill it out every single year for the following year.
Okay. What are the basic requirements for FAFSA eligibility?
So there's really no eligibility. It's just going to school, going to college. That's literally all that's eligible. But when you are doing the application, it's you and your parent. So the student does a portion of it and the parent does a portion of it. You fill out stuff like if you've had a job and there's some things like that, but mainly it's based on your parents' income and their tax information.
And then can you explain the difference between grants, loans, and work study programs?
So grants is, like I said, free money. Like you're getting that free money. They're just giving it to you. You never have to pay it back. The loans you have to pay back, and they have some that students can get, and you it accrues interest while you're in school. Some don't accrue interest until you've finished. And some are for parents, and they accrue interest. Now, you don't have to start paying any of this back until 6 months after you finish school, or you stop going to school, even if you don't graduate. That's when you have to start paying it back.
And then, last question. What is the verification process and why might a student be selected for it?
So that's totally up to the school, the college. So once, when you're filling it out, you indicate on there what schools you want them to send it to. So you're just doing one application and they can send it to Baylor and to A&M and to Lamar and wherever, LIT, anything. And then once they get it, they assess it. And when you're accepted to the school, you know, you create an account. It sends you information, set up this account. And then it's going to tell you, this is what we'll give you. We will give you this much free money. We will give you this much loan. And it's different per school. So it's up to them what they give you. Like if you're going to go to Baylor, it costs a lot more money. They give you a lot more, but it still costs a lot. You know, if you're going to LIT, you're going to get less money. Also, it's dependent on what your parents make. And, you know, so the less they make, the more money you get.
Okay. Well, that was FAFSA info. So thank you, Miss McLeod.
Thanks, Miss McLeod. We know that we'll keep hearing, fill out your FAFSA, but we really do appreciate you.
It's competition season. Last week, we heard about our cheer team. This week, we'll check in with our dance team, the Starlettes.
What's up, guys? I'm Roland Phelps, and I'm here with Leah Broussard and McKenna Callis, two of our Starlettes on the Starlet Squad. How are y'all doing today?
Great.
Good, I'm good. So, I know that y'all have upcoming competition, and I wanted to ask y'all a little bit about that. And so, y'all have dress rehearsal first, is that right?
Yes,
it's this Saturday.
Okay, so I wanted to know a little bit about that first.
Okay, so the officers, which is Leah, Kate, me, Tori, and Mary Grace, but Mary Grace will not be attending competition this year. So this Saturday, the officers have to be in the China Elementary Gym at 9 in the morning with our hair and makeup done, fully dressed and everything. And we're going to practice until 5 or later or earlier. We never know. But just to get us ready, we're going to run through all the dances, clean some warm, you know, just get us really prepared for this
quick lunch.
Yes. Like a 30-minute lunch between all of that.
And we're not stopping.
We're not stopping.
All right, so besides dress rehearsal, I want to know what all goes into the preparation for competition.
We started learning the dances like 2 months ago, and we have three different routines. We have a jazz, a novelty, and a hip-hop, and they're all like 2 minutes and a half, I think.
Yes. Yeah. Novelty is 3 minutes.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure, yes.
Yeah, and we just finished the poem not too long ago. We're still working really hard, and we had tryouts, actually. We're just keep going, and we changed all of our formations, and we're doing perfectly fine right now. We just need a little bit more time, and we got it.
So upcoming competition, I want to know a little bit about that. So when is it, and what happens during all that?
We leave Friday the 2nd, and then we actually do our dances on February 3rd, and we're going out to eat Friday, and we have like lunches, like Chick-fil-A and Jimmy John's and everything, got to pick what you wanted, and yeah. And we have like, our group dances are in the morning, and then our solos are at night, right? Yeah.
Yes, but it's like a whole day process. Like, so like our first like duets, they go at like 8 in the morning, and then we compete like spread times apart until what, like 7, 8 at night. But after like we all compete, then we do awards, which is like the best part of it all. We all get to dress up. It's really cute. It's really fun.
All right. Well, thank y'all.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Hockey, yeah.
Hockey, yeah.
Oh wait.
Now to report on a very different kind of competition, one that we don't usually hear much about, but that Kenley Smith has been killing it in.
Hey guys, I'm here with Kenley, and this weekend it looks like she had some pretty exciting plans, so can you tell us a little bit about what you did?
Yes, so this week I was in Lexington, Kentucky at the Eastern Regional Finals for the American Rodeo, which is a $1 million rodeo, and I am in the process of qualifying to get there. And so I have made it through two sets of qualifiers, and now I'm going to Abilene to the last set, and I have to be in the top 5 there, and then I make it to the actual American, where I will compete for $1 million.
So for the people that don't know what breakaway roping is, what is that?
So breakaway roping is the female version of tie-down roping. So the girls, including myself, will go out there and rope a calf, and our rope is tied on to our saddle with a very tiny piece of string. So when my horse stops and the calf keeps roping, my rope will break the string, and that's when the time stops. So basically, you just have to go out there and rope the calf as fast as you can.
And is everything you do on the same horse, or do you have more than one?
I have two horses. I have a practice horse and I have a competition horse. I do practice like on my competition horse probably like a day or two before I go somewhere to compete, and I'll run like two or three calves on him. And his name is Moody. I've had him for a little over 2 years.
Is Moody moody?
Yes, Moody is very moody. His name fits him well. I did not name him. He already had that name, but it fits him very well.
What do you do with the money that you've won from all the different rodeos that you go to?
It goes back into my bank account to enter and travel to more rodeos.
Kinley will be competing on February 10th in Abilene, so everyone make sure to tell her good luck.
Thanks, guys.
First place in the Buckle are pretty sweet, but how about 10 bands, buddy? That's some cash.
All I know is that I better not catch her lacking, or I'm going to be 10K richer.
Maybe.
Possibly. Sticking with the competition theme, our UIL Academics team kicked off their season in Nederland last weekend. Big shout out to Terriana Kennedy. She placed 5th in headline riding. This was her first time competing. Man, I was almost late the first period this morning because I could not get through the hallway. I felt like just to get through, I needed to go be in lineman mode.
Maybe this little PSA will strike some people out a little bit.
This is why headphones are a no-no in the hallway.
Kendall! Carrington! Kendall! Carrington! Kendall! Carrington! Kendall!
Oh! Hey!
No PDA.
This is why we don't run in the hallways.
Don't crowd the staircase.
This is why we don't crowd the halls. And that was hallway etiquette.
Seeing people macking in the hallways just might be bottom five ever.
Now, breaking a good bit of those aforementioned rules are some of our favorite segments, in the halls and out and about.
Hey guys, I'm London.
And I'm Kinley.
And this is Out and About.
Are you going to ask Caitlin to be your Valentine?
Yep, I already did.
How did you do it?
I told her to flip the car, like, window, like the, how you look at yourself in the car. Uh-huh. And it flipped down and said, how you doing?
So Will asked you to be his Valentine, right?
Yes.
What would you rate how he asked you? Like, out of 10.
A 10?
What would you want a guy to ask you to be his Valentine?
Probably with a big sign and flowers with some candy too.
Are you going to ask somebody to be your Valentine this year?
I already got one.
Oh, well, wait! How are you going to ask her to be your Valentine?
You have to do that.
Are you asking someone to be your Valentine this year?
Indeed.
What are you going to do? How are you going to ask her?
I'm probably going to get some balloons and maybe some chocolates, and I'm probably going to surprise her and say, will you be my Valentine's?
Friends?
Yeah.
Hi, guys. It's Carrington.
And Kendall, and we're back with In the Halls.
And today, we're going to be asking you either or questions.
Let's go.
Country or rap?
Country.
Hot Cheetos or Takis?
Hot Cheetos.
Yeah. Hot or cold weather?
Hot.
Chick-fil-A or Cane's?
Obviously it's Chick-fil-A because I go there every day.
Chick-fil-A or Cane's?
Cane's.
No!
Chick-fil-A or Cane's?
Chick-fil-A.
Nike or Adidas?
Nike.
Cold weather or hot weather?
Hot.
Hot Cheetos or Takis?
Takis.
Pancakes or waffles?
Pancakes.
What do you think? Tots.
Fries.
Apple Music or Spotify?
Spotify.
Ew.
Beyonce or Rihanna?
Rihanna, Team Rihanna. If you don't like Rihanna, you just big backed.
Kendall or Carrington?
Man, that's a hard choice. One's D1 in softball, one's D1 in basketball. But then again, one's dating an overhyped wide receiver with no touchdowns against HJ. So. Just kidding. We love them both.
Cool. I know you're a big movie guy. What's your favorite movie line? It doesn't matter. Me and Coco did a little challenge. We just guessed movie lines. It's pretty easy.
What's up, y'all? We are back with another challenge accepted. I know you missed us because we missed you.
We did.
So this is what we're gonna do. And we've done a few physical objects, challenges. So what we're going to do now for this week is we're going to do movie quotes.
Bring it back to the brain a little bit.
Yeah, we're
not too good at those from past experiences.
Yeah, so rule change, we're going to 7.
Alright, I am your father.
Star Wars.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh man. 1970.
No. 1983.
No.
Ah.
It was 1980.
90?
1980.
Oh, okay.
Be Their Hero, Clark.
Oh my god, Clark. Where'd I know that from?
I don't know this movie.
The reason I say Clark is like, is it, Christmas Vacation? Clark.
Holy moly, no. 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 No.
Superman.
Yeah.
Yes. Clark Kent or something like that? Clark. 1998.
Mm. Ogres are like onions.
What?
Trick.
Yes.
Oh, I'm so dumb.
Wait, whoa. Calm down. Ogres are like 2011.
Nah.
2003.
No.
Oh.
2001.
Oh. 2-1.
You're a wizard, Harry.
Harry Potter.
No, I think of a tie.
Oh, actually?
Yeah.
We're gonna pick my favorite episode for.
Okay. Yeah, 2001.
Yeah, you got it.
Woo!
That's 3 for Coco.
Let's go, boys. No,
that's 4.
That's 4.
That's 4?
Got 2, and that's plus 2. Now.
Okay, so 4-1?
4-1, yeah.
Okay. Where's my super suit? Yeah, I was another.
Oh, that wasn't that time.
The Incredibles.
Yeah.
Let's be serious now. Hold on.
That's a tough
2009.
No.
Okay, 4-3.
4-2. I am Iron Man.
Well, what the?
It's Iron Man.
Yeah, okay.
But some of these I just did them off like whoever.
Yeah.
Faster.
Yeah.
Alright. We're gonna call that like 2007.
No.
2002.
No, it was 2008.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, I was so close.
Come on. Alright, 4-3.
You wanna know how I got these scars?
Oh my. What is that from?
It's Batman.
Yes, it is.
Oh my Joker, bro.
Batman's old though.
I feel like
1999.
No.
Far.
2013.
No.
Far.
2008.
Far, dude. Gosh.
Is it 4-4?
Score check.
4-4, I think.
Yeah.
That was another talk.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Toy Story. Yeah.
Which one?
2002.
No.
2001.
No. With great power comes great responsibility.
Oh my gosh, what is that from?
Star Wars. Is it not?
No.
Wait, which with great power?
No, am I tripping?
With great power comes great power.
Oh my god, I actually just...
Spider-Man?
Yes.
My favorite, like, movie.
2004.
No.
Spider-Man's, like, kind of new, huh?
But we're gonna
this is the first one.
2001.
No, it was 2002.
Oh.
Yeah. Alright, 6-5. No, 6-4.
Yeah.
Avengers Assemble.
Avengers game. Hawkeye, my favorite.
Isn't your...
What was he right?
Yeah, you're fuck.
It says Avengers in the movie.
Alright, it could have been any.
Okay. And just for the kill shot, let's go 2007.
Like 2010.
2011.
Bro, I'm not gonna hold you. I've gotten within one on every single year. Like.
Alright guys, as you can tell, I became the victor. I was up a lot, he came back, but then you know who won. I won 7-4. So for our tie board this week, we're gonna do is The score now is tied 3-3. So now it's 4-3. So you know, we'll catch y'all next week. We don't know what it's gonna be, or else I'll give y'all some hint, but we don't care.
We usually just come up on the fly.
Yeah, so we'll see y'all when we fly over there. Y'all have a great weekend.
Yeah, I'm gonna be real with you. I thought it was gonna be pretty easy, but I lost.
Hey, can't win them all, you know.
It's whatever.
It's probably a quote from the movie or something. You wouldn't know. Let's go to Cole, Brighton, and Luke to learn a little bit more about what's going on. HJ Sports.
You already know who it is. It's your favorite sports anchors. And starting off the segment strong, we're going to take it back to last Friday, where our girls basketball team took on Liberty for the district championship. They won with a score of 77-38, and Kendall Sneed absolutely dominated, scoring 41 points and pushing them past the Panthers.
This wasn't just any win for the Lady Hawks. Last Friday was a little more special. Here's Xander and Wyatt with Coach Fogo.
Coach Fogo, you've had great success with your girls' teams. How do you feel going into the playoffs this year?
Pretty good. We're on a good track right now and hope to kind of sustain what we're doing and add to it.
Absolutely.
All right.
Coach Fogo, what keeps you motivated through your seasons of success?
I want to make sure none of my players get arrested or live with their parents when they're 25.
That's a great answer. And last question, Coach Fogo. What is your favorite thing about this specific group of girls this year?
Most of the older ones have been around since they were 6 or 7 years old. So watching them grow through the years has been fun.
Absolutely. What about this new group coming up? What excites you about that?
The younger group?
Yes, sir.
They work hard and they're receptive to learning some new stuff.
Absolutely. I appreciate you, Coach Fogo.
Hey, no problem.
Who's your favorite player on this team since Fogo can't answer that?
I'm also going to plead the fifth.
Which has been your favorite memory so far with this team?
I would just say the camaraderie of everyone. Everyone knows how to play together as a team, and we all just have fun, and then we ball out and do what we do on the court.
Who's the player that shows the most leadership on the floor?
That's a good one. I honestly think from the older girls, they know how to guide and show what the other girls need to do, so they kind of just like fall in place with each other. So everyone pretty much takes their own leadership role.
How do you feel about Coach Fogo's music taste?
Honestly, those are the jams.
Congrats, Coach. We can't wait to see y'all in the playoff. Moving on now, boys basketball hosted West Fork last Wednesday, and they dominated them, winning 94-34. They also hosted Liberty Friday and won 69-44. The boys are hot, trying to keep their playoff hopes alive.
Well, guys, soccer season is really heating up. Our girls took on Bridge City at home to start off district, and they put on a show, winning 4-0. Some big-time goals came from Tori Novak, Heidi Pullenbert, Kendall Begno, and Addison Robinson.
Boys also started district play, traveling to Bridge City last Friday, and due to weather, only played the first half. There are plans on finishing that game at a later date.
Powerlifting had a meet last Thursday, and they had a great day. Trinity Moody, Alondra Gomez, Elena Jackson, and Haley Crawford all placed first in their weight class. Our girls' team placed third overall. Now for the boys. Justin Tran and Caden Salinas both placed first in their weight classes, and the boys' team placed fourth overall. Great job, guys.
Our swim team just wrapped up their season, and we have a couple of swimmers headed to regionals later this week.
I'm Jada Reeves, and we're here with some of those swimmers that qualify for regionals. This is Addison Robinson and Ryland Schaefer. So, tell us about the process of getting to regionals, I guess.
The process to get in the regionals is you have to qualify for, you have to place top four out of the whole district. Mm-hmm. So, the way we did that was Addison swam the 50 free and placed number four, and I swam the 50 breast and the, no, not the 50 breast, the 100 breast and the 50 free, and I qualified both fourth place for those.
So, could you just explain what the 50 free is? I mean, some of these people probably don't know it.
So, it's basically like a down and back, mm-hmm. and that's, you just swim down and swim back.
All right, easy enough, I guess. So, swim's like your main sport, huh?
Yeah, and I also run track and field, and I perform in pole vault, and I participate in the marching band, and I play trombone.
Awesome. What else do you do?
I do a lot. So my primary sport is soccer. I'm on the varsity soccer team, and then I'm also doing varsity softball, and then I'm also doing track.
He gets you everything.
Yes.
Yeah. So I guess regionals is next. So what's after that? When is regionals? And
regionals is this starts and we lead off for this Friday, and regionals is held at Lamar High School in Houston, and after that it's to see if we qualify for state or not. And the way we get to qualify for state is if we make top two or top four for that.
So this is your first time to qualify for regionals, or have you done
that
before?
It's my first time qualifying for regionals. I swam before over there at a different school, but the way the district I swam for, it was really high district, so it's my first chance ever getting to qualify for regionals here.
So everyone knows our swimming pool's on the roof. Is that like an extra challenge getting up there, or do y'all just have to go somewhere else?
No, the pool isn't on the roof. It's actually, we go to the Beaumont ISD pool.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thanks. All right, I guess that's it for our interview. Good luck at regionals.
Good luck, guys. Well, that's all the sports we had this week. We will catch y'all next week. This has been
AJ Sports.
Friday night is senior night for our girls' basketball. Be sure to come out and celebrate Hawks Nest on Cassidy Riley and Kendall Sneed.
As you can see, soccer season is in full swing. So let's go ahead and meet some Hawks and start with the girls. While we're on the topic of meeting Hawks, let's meet our golf players, eh?
Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. Did I get delivered here? Somebody tell me, please.
Weather.
What's up, guys? It's Beezy, and I'm back with your weekly weather report. Welcome back. I hope all of you had a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. It's been really cold these past few days, and Thursday and Friday is going to be even colder, with Friday having a little rain in the forecast. This weekend is going to be cold, but sunny as well. It's sweater weather week, so make sure you stay in the house and be warm. Till next time.
Woo! That sure was a busy week. Yeah. But it was so much fun, wasn't it, Brayden?
I had a blast.
But unfortunately, all good things must come to an end.
It hurts every time you gotta leave.
It breaks my heart. I just wish I could sit at this table and read lines off an iPad all day.
Every day.
24/7.
I'd do it for free.
Thanks for free hand. So unfortunately, guys, we're going to let you go here. But we will be seeing you next week on Hawks.